everyone, and welcome back to our Bible class today. We have been studying the life of Moses. Moses is one of the most important people in the Old Testament. He even wrote the first five books of the Old Testament. Do you remember what the first five books are called? The Pentateuch, that's right. And Moses wrote all five books. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. We have been studying from the book of Exodus in our Bibles, and that's what we're going to continue to do. I hope that you are ready to sing a few songs and then learn a little bit more about Moses and the Hebrews or the Israelites. First, let's sing a song all about the Bible. I love the Bible. The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. The B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I'll read and study and then obey, the B-I-B-L-E. The B-I-B-L-E, I'll handle carefully. I will not chew or tear or rip my B-I-B-L-E. It's very important to be careful with our Bibles. Sometimes when we're really little, we need to be taught to just pat the Bible. Can you pat your Bible? That's a good way to be nice and gentle. As we get older and we learn to open our Bibles and turn to the different pages, we need to be very careful because Bibles have very thin pages. And so we need to turn the pages very carefully. Why do we want to be so careful with our Bibles? It's important that we read them. It's important that we use them. We don't want to just put them on a shelf and never touch our Bibles. We want to read our Bibles. But it's important to be careful because the Bible is God's Word. And so every word that the Bible says is very important. And so we don't want to tear the pages because then we might not be able to read certain parts of our Bible. And we don't want to draw all over the words because then we wouldn't be able to read those words. And every single word is important in our Bibles. And so we always want to take care of our Bibles, to love our Bibles, pat our Bibles, to turn the pages very carefully, and to always read and study from our Bibles. You might see your mommy or daddy, your grandparent, your preacher, you might see them write in their Bibles sometimes. I like to do that. But we're being very careful and taking very careful notes in our Bible while we learn new things. And so taking notes in your Bible is okay, but you want to be very careful when you do that. And if mommy or daddy are taking notes in their Bible, be careful not to bump their arms and make them mess up in their Bibles. Because again, the Bible is so important, and we want to take very good care of our Bibles. Love the Bible. Love the Bible. It is God's Word. Love the Bible. Love the Bible. It is God's Word. Read your Bible. Read your Bible. It is God's Word. Read your Bible, read your Bible. It is God's Word. Do you remember how many books are in the Bible? 66. That's a lot of books. But I think that today we can probably do all 66 books of the Bible. Do you think so? We've been learning the books of the Old Testament, and it's pretty tricky. But we have a song that we sing that helps us to learn, and I also know a song about the New Testament books. So today we're going to sing both of them. Let's start with the Old Testament, because remember, the Bible is divided into two parts, the Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament was written the longest amount of time ago, and the New Testament is the law that we are under. It's the times of Jesus, and we live under the law of Christ. So let's start by singing the books of the Old Testament. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. Those were the 39 books of the Old Testament. So that leaves 27 books for the New Testament. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Acts and the letter to the Romans, 1st and 2nd Corinthians, Galatians and Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1st and 2nd Thessalonians, 1st and 2nd Timothy, Titus and Philemon, Hebrews, James, 1st and 2nd Peter, 1st and 2nd and 3rd John, Jude and Revelation. You did a great job. It's always good to be still and to listen while we have Bible class, but it's also really, really good to sing along and to sing praises to God. God loves to hear you sing. Did you know that? God can hear you anytime you sing. And so you can always sing to God, and He loves, loves, loves to hear you sing. So let's think back to what book we've been talking about in our Bibles. We've been in the Old Testament, in the second book of the Bible, which is Exodus. That's right. We've been in Exodus talking about Moses. Moses was a very, very important man, and he had a very important job from God. And we've been talking about that for the last few weeks. God had a special plan for Moses. Now, for the last 2 weeks, we've been talking about the plagues. How many plagues were there? 10 plagues. And after the last plague, which was the death of the firstborn, what a sad plague. After that, Pharaoh finally let the Hebrew people go. And that's where we're going to start today with our story. It was time for the Hebrew people to leave. Pharaoh wanted them all to go. And remember, they had the jewelry and the different things that they were taking from the Egyptians, and they were getting out. They were going to leave and take all their stuff and their animals, and they were going to get out of Egypt. God was going to lead them. And do you know that there was a very special way that God was leading them? God led them in the daytime with a cloud, and at nighttime, a pillar of fire, so they could always know where to go because they could follow God. And so during the day, they could see before them that there was this big cloud, and they could follow that and know that God was leading them. And then at nighttime, when it got dark, they didn't have to be afraid, and they could still see where they were going because God was leading them in a pillar of fire. But guess what? Do you remember when we were studying about the plagues, especially the first 9 plagues? That when Moses and Aaron would go to Pharaoh and tell him the message from God, that Pharaoh would often change his mind. He would say, okay, take that plague away and you can let the people go. But when the plague went away, like the frogs or the gnats or the flies, or when the locusts went away, whenever that would happen, Pharaoh would change his mind and he wouldn't let the people go. Well, guess what? After the 10th plague, when Pharaoh says, let the people go, he's very sad because his son has died. He changed his mind again. But this time, the people were already gone. They were already out of Egypt and in the wilderness on their way to the promised land. The children of Israel got a little scared though. because they knew that Pharaoh was coming. And do you know that Pharaoh was coming with 600 chariots? That would have been so scary if you knew that those chariots were chasing you. Now remember, we said that God was doing something very special in leading the Israelites. He was there as a pillar of a cloud in the daytime and a pillar of fire at nighttime. Did the Israelites need to be afraid? No, God was with them. Did they need to whine? No, God was with them and God was taking care of them, because remember, God had a plan the whole time. But they got scared. And so God led them to the Red Sea. Now, have you ever been to the ocean or to the river or to a lake? Have you ever been somewhere where there was a lot of water? Can you walk on the water? I can't. When I get in the water, I sink. Or I have to swim. But it would have been very hard for the people to walk through a really deep sea. And so they felt like they were stuck. And the Israelites, because they were scared and they were already whining, they started just complaining and whining to Moses about God. Now that wasn't the way they should act. They should have trusted God, because God was going to do something very, very special. It was going to be a miracle, and it was a wonderful thing that was going to happen. So, Pharaoh, after he changed his mind, he brought 600 chariots and he chased after the Israelites. And the Israelites were going in the wilderness toward the sea. And God, instead of being before them in the pillar of the cloud and the fire, instead he moved from in front of them behind them. And so he was between the Israelites and the Egyptians. He was keeping them safe. And he told Moses to stretch out his staff, or his stick. And he told him to stretch that out, and that God was going to do something special to the Red Sea. The Red Sea was going to be parted. They were going to get to go to the water, and then it was going to be dry ground that they were going to get to just walk through the sea. And so the Bible tells us that there was a strong wind that God used to push back the sea, and that the water stood up on both sides like a wall, and they got to walk through the sea. Now that is something that hasn't happened again, not like this. God did something very amazing. And God would do something very similar a little later in the book of Joshua. He would do it with Joshua and the Israelites again, but not quite like this. And definitely not in our lifetime. I've never seen something like that happen. Your parents have never seen something like that. Not even your grandparents or your great, 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 great grandparents. Nobody has ever seen something this wonderful before. God was really taking care of the Israelites, and so he let them walk through the Red Sea on dry ground. It wasn't even muddy. That was amazing. That was a miracle. God is so good, and he took care of the Israelites the whole time, because they were God's special people. And God had promised that he was going to get them out of Egypt. Now, when they got through the Red Sea, the waters went back down. But Pharaoh and his chariots had been chasing the Israelites, and so the water swallowed them up. Pharaoh should have listened to God, and he shouldn't have kept changing his mind. Do you know that we should always obey God? And we should always listen. That's really, really important. But we shouldn't just listen to God, and we shouldn't just obey God. We should do those things. Always listen, always obey. But do you know what else we should do? The Israelites did something that we don't want to do. The Israelites were whining. Have your parents ever told you that you were whining? Me too. Have you ever whined? Me too. But the Israelites, they were whining, and God didn't like that. Do you know why God doesn't like that? Because God always takes care of us. That's why your parents don't like it when you whine either, because your parents take care of you too. The Israelites didn't have to be afraid, because God was going to protect them and keep them safe and get them where they needed to go, even if it meant that they were going to walk right through the Red Sea. The Israelites didn't know that could even happen. But did you know that the Bible tells us with God, all things are possible? God can do anything because God made the whole world. I'm so glad that God is my Father and that He's going to take care of me. And I don't have to be afraid because God is in charge. God is in control. I just have to trust Him, listen, and obey. That's why we read our Bibles. Because we want to listen to what God says, and then we want to do it. And then we want to have those words in our hearts so that we don't have to be afraid. We can know that just like God was with the Israelites, God's with us. God is never going to leave us. He is always with us, and He loves us so much. So we don't have to whine. We don't have to be afraid. Instead, we always listen and obey. God is so good. Would you like to sing a song about how good God is? I love to sing and praise God, and I think that now would be a really good time to praise God. Because, guess what? After the Israelites and Moses went through the Red Sea, they also sang a song. Because God is just so good. And sometimes when you stop and you think about how good God is, it's hard to not just start singing. That's why a lot of times when we're at worship to God, we sing a lot of songs, because it feels so good to sing from our hearts to God about how great He is. Let's sing a song about God. God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. God is so good to you, to me. God was so good to the Israelites. God was so good to Moses. Because God is good. God is good to everyone. Now, we should always listen, always obey, never whine. We don't want to do that, because we know that God will take care of us. I'm so glad that you've been here with me to talk about Moses, and especially today to talk about the Red Sea parting and becoming like a big wall where they could walk through on dry land. That was a miracle. God is so good, and God does so many great things. That's why you should read your Bible and get your parents to read you Bible stories so that you can learn all about how good God is and all of the amazing things that God has done. God has done a lot of amazing things. And so there are lots of stories that we can read from our Bibles to know all about the cool things that God has done. I'm so glad you've been with me today. I hope that you'll be back with me next time. It's a lot of fun to get to have Bible class with you, and I hope I see you again soon. Bye.